LG is one of the brands that doesn't really focuses much on the budget segment here in India, but with LG Q6, it surely has made an impact in the Indian market with that 5.5 inch full vision display, or some people like to call it bezel-less display, but that's not a bezel-less display. But does that mean that you should get one? Well, that's why I'm here, right? Hey guys, this is Saurabh Nahar here from Alva Technologies, and you are watching my review on the LG Q6. Let's begin. Now, before even starting this video, I would like to mention that I am highly disappointed with LG because they have not given a basic feature like fingerprint sensor on a device which is for about 15,000 rupees. I mean, the devices that are available for 7,000 rupees, they come with a fingerprint sensor. Then why not a fingerprint sensor? It's weird. Like, it's 2017. Wake up, LG. And people who are thinking like there is face unlock, well, face unlock works, but it doesn't really work all the time. It won't really work at night time. Plus, it is not secure and fast like a fingerprint sensor. So let's not talk about it. As always, let's start with build quality, design and in-hand feel. The device is well built and thus comes with 7000 series aluminum frame. But why not unibody metal? I don't understand. As this device anyways comes with a non-removable rear panel. Also, this plastic back cover gets scratched up very easily, which is something that disappointed me on the very first day. Design-wise, it looks modern on the front and absolutely old from the rear side. I don't know why they went with such design, but yes, not the best looking device from the rear side. In terms of feel, it's very compact even with that 5.5 inch display when compared to other devices, and is not very slippery, but still would recommend you to go with a case. Now let's talk about that display. It's a 5.5 inch 18:9 1080 by 2160 display with Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection on top. Display in my opinion is good, but a bit more sharper to my liking. Viewing angles, no issues whatsoever, and even outdoor visibility is fine. But due to that 18:9 aspect ratio, you might get to see black bars while watching YouTube and playing games. But if you wish to play in full screen anyway, just swipe up and the app should load in full screen. Overall, display is the most strongest point about this device. Also, LG is giving free screen replacement within 6 months of purchase in case it gets damaged. Talking about the battery life on the LG Q6, it is sort of average in my opinion. It's not that great. If you want great battery life, check out Redmi Note 4 or Lenovo P2. With this device, you will get 4 to 5 hours of max screen on time. And if you are like me who uses WhatsApp, social media applications and a little bit of YouTube videos, then it should be fine for a day. But if you are a very heavy user, then you will surely have to charge your device by the end of the day. And the charger that they have provided is, oh my God, it is a 1.2 amp charger. It is not even a 2 amp charger. So it is a huge disappointment. And I don't know why they did cost cutting over here. I mean, why, LG? Why? Now, just as I said in my unboxing, I'm repeating again, speaker is not so impressive. And it's not the loudest also. You won't miss the calls, but surely it will disappoint when you watch something on that beautiful looking display. And I know you might be like, I'll use earphones, but let me tell you, the output on the earphones is also low. And if you are someone who likes to listen to music or watch videos at low volume and not the max volume, then it should be fine for you. But I am someone who listens on the max volume and it disappointed me. Let's talk about performance now. So this is where LG did the major cost cutting. Snapdragon 435 is a good chipset for a budget device for 6000 to 7000, but for a device which is priced at 14999, it's not that great. Don't get me wrong, it can handle basic tasks and gaming well when it comes to casual games and high-end games with little bit of frame drops and lags, but multitasking is just bad even with 3GB of RAM. Most of the apps reloaded in my testing. Also, app opening time is not so fast like other devices in this particular price range. So in performance and multitasking, it's not the best device. On a side note, this device does comes with 32GB of internal storage and 3GB of RAM, and you can expand storage up to 2TB if you wish to with the dedicated SD card slot, which is great in my opinion. Software on this device is skinned and does comes with features, but I would still prefer clean and stock UI over this UI. Last but one of the most important thing, how are the cameras on the Q6? Well, I have mixed opinions about it. First, let's talk about front camera. It is impressive as it comes with 100 degree wide angle lens, which is capable of capturing decent images in good lighting. Although as expected, performs badly in low light situations and indoors. If we talk about the rear camera, it is capable of clicking good images in good lighting with good amount of detail, colors and dynamic range. Even in indoors with some light, it's fine, but it performs very bad in low light situations and you can see a lot of noise in images. Also, point to be noted here is that focusing time is little slow because there is no phase detection autofocus or laser autofocus on this device, but EIS actually works amazing on this device and you can see how stable the footage is.
So guys, right now I am shooting this video with the rear facing camera of the LG Q6, so you can judge the quality of the stabilization of the video. And also let me show you how is the focusing on this device. So you can see the focusing is not the fastest that I've seen, but yeah, it does the decent job. And there's no 4K recording over here on this device, so that's how it is. And yeah, let me know how is the quality of the video.
So should you get the LG Q6? Well, honestly, I won't. I want simple UI, performance, good battery life if not fast charging, and good cameras, which this device totally lacks. The display is good and yeah, that's about it. Everything else is just mediocre. It's not the best. So I won't really get this device. But if you still want to get this device and if you are ready to compromise and you have already fallen for that display, then check out the link in the description box and do use my link. That will definitely help out the channel. So guys, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button and let's see if we can get 999 likes on this one or not. So hit that like button and let's see. If you are new to the channel, then definitely hit that red subscribe button and click that bell icon so that you don't miss out such amazing reviews on my channel. And make sure to follow me on all my social media networks. Links are there in the description box. Do follow me on Instagram and Twitter because I'm very active on those two platforms. And if you have any questions or queries, you can ask me over there or in the comment section. That's it guys. This is Saurabh Nahar from Alva Technologies. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.